Hi there. Welcome. Our story about finding friendship, hope, and community through music is about to unfold. Enjoy.
My name is Edwin Huizinga, and I have spent the last 32 years of my life playing the violin. We're living in a time that none of us have ever experienced before, and I've been in my little studio home in Bonnie Doon these last few months recording and practicing and learning new repertoire. And then all of a sudden, one day, a few months ago, I got a little message from a woman named Michelle Djokic.
My name's Michelle Djokic. I'm a cellist.
And it said something like, "Hey, Edwin, I'm in Carmel by the sea."
So when COVID set in and found myself playing a lot. I found myself just totally immersed in practicing more than ever. And the solo working was getting really lonely. I was thinking, who can I turn to?
I wrote her back immediately and I was like, "Oh my gosh, Michelle, yes, I'm around. And I've been home alone practicing Bach for going on 242 days. And I'm really wondering if I'm going crazy." So all of a sudden I found myself in Carmel by the Sea at Michelle Djokic's house playing my favorite violin and cello repertoire in the whole world.
Thank you.
Michelle and I would not have connected this summer under normal circumstances because we were both absolutely, totally, fully booked. And so when I came to Michelle's house and we started playing music, I was just dumbfounded with this unbelievable sense of knowing her well. I was like, wow, have we done this before? Like, I just felt this overwhelming sense of gratitude for that moment.
And mine was out of reach.
Why did it turn off?
Mine was like out of reach and you're going to look bang.
I literally checked it.
We really have learned so much about each other just on the spot in terms of trust and understanding how much we can lean on the other person when we're not quite sure what's happening. But, you know, we're going to be there for each other, whatever it is that happens. And that is something you truly learn in chamber music about your colleague.
Thank you.
one afternoon while we were playing together, we just looked at Michelle's deck and we said to each other, we can play music right here for people. We can invite a handful of people to sit extremely safely, far apart, outside, socially distanced. And we started figuring out how to put like these little pods together on the deck, of like a pod of two for a couple, or a pod of one for someone that wanted to come hear us by themselves. And we realized that our maximum sold out limit was 10. Applause, by the way, is a very strange sound if you haven't heard it for several months.
It was very emotional, just seeing people, the look in people's eyes, the, of anticipation, not just share the music, but the story of our being here. The whole narrative was something that felt so special. Afterwards, all I could think was, my gosh, I haven't felt nervous in such a long time. You know, I haven't had that sense of, oh, we're going to play a concert. Come on, come on.
Positive thinking is not that easy to do right now during this pandemic. But here we are, so grateful and happy to be making music in this moment. Thank you. what gives me hope? Michelle gives me hope because we are able to create something that I feel is so beautiful and magical in this moment together.
But I'm eternally grateful to have met Edwin and have this new friendship that, I mean, come on, this is an epic summer. We've lived, it's like we wrote an entire chapter right here. We saw from the beginning to where we are today, and if you asked me if this was going to happen this summer, I would have never guessed this is going to be my summer of 2020, Manzanita Music Collective with Edwin. I never would have imagined this, and here it is. We have so many stories and so many occasions and so many beautiful moments of sharing that were magic. Despite everything else, it was absolute magic.
I think that as long as there are people in this world that are seeking to share beautiful moments with other people, that we will be able to continue to survive. I'm really hopeful because Michelle and I started something really small, and I think it's really beautiful.
When I see that people still need music and they still need community and that they still want to come together, that gives me great hope. And sure, we have to be careful for a while, and we're all being as careful as we can be. We need to be that way. But the fact that there's still this desire to share in culture and share in community, that's my sense of hope.